we are going to discuss the match function. The match function is useful when you have, for example, we have existing account numbers, and I have about 400 or 500 of them in this list. And then I have new numbers, and let's say you wanted to check to see if these numbers already existed. So what you would do is you would go equals match. Then you put opening bracket, and then you would match the number here, which is B2, and you put a comma, and then you're going to match from the whole list. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on the first cell here, and we're going to press Control Shift down arrow to get to the bottom of the list. Okay, and then we're going to put in another comma here, and we're going to put in 0 for an exact match. And then we're going to scroll back up to the top, and then we'll press Enter. So it returns NA, and so let's double click that down. And so the ones that it does find, it returns the relative position that it is in the list next to it. Now, what they're talking about here is, so it returns 498 appears relative to 24. So this one is, we have our titles in the first line, so this is, we're going to count 4 and plus the 24. And then if we scroll down to line 28, there we find our 498. It's certainly interesting, but it's difficult to work with. So let's just have it tell us whether the match actually exists. So let's go back into our formula. And let's go put an if in front of this. And what we're going to do is we're going to say if this is a number, then you return yes. And if it's not a number, then maybe you can return no. So let's go in front of our match. Let's go if. And then I'm going to go is number. And then I'm going to go another opening bracket. And then I'm going to put another opening bracket behind this one. And then I'm going to put a comma. And so if that's true, we're going to say yes. And if that's false, we're going to say no. And we're going to close our brackets and see what it says. And so it says no, so let's click on that, and let's double click on the fill handle here. And so there, by putting is number and an if function around it, it makes it a little more useful. At least it tells you definitely whether there is a match in the other range of this number. So there you have the match function. Please subscribe.